when he was dealing with that ship, because all I did was put up what he was talking about, but I didn't break it down. So I'm gonna break it down in James, the third chapter, around the fifth and sixth verse. Okay, what he mentioned. So the brother that was standing on the other side last week, what he was talking about. Go ahead, bro.
All right, this is James chapter 3, verse 5. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasteth great things.
What verse is that?
Alright, this is James chapter 3.
Him. Yeah, yeah. You got it. You're dealing with the ship and the him.
Alright, this is James chapter 3, verse 4. Behold, also the ships, which though they be so great and are driven of fierce winds, yet are they churned about with a very small helm,
yep,
whithersoever the governor listeth. Mm-hmm. Listeth. Verse 5. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasteth great things. Mm-hmm. Behold, how great a matter a little fire kindleth. Mm-hmm. Verse 6. And the tongue is a fire, a world of iniquity. So is the tongue among our members, that it defileth the whole body, and setteth on fire the course of nature, and it is set on fire of hell.
Okay, start back up.
All right, this is James chapter 3, verse 4. Behold, also the ships, which though they be so great and are driven of fierce winds, yet are they turned about with a very small helm.
So we're going to look up that word helm right there, right? Let me see if I can grab it real quick. James 3. Let's see here in the blue letter. What verse is that?
Four.
All right, we looking up the word him. Right?
Paidalion.
And it's a ship's rubber. So, alright, and what I want to do, it says the ship's rubber. So what I want to do is go to Google, right? Ship's helm.
According to Wikipedia, a ship's wheel or boat's wheel is a device used aboard a water vessel to steer that vessel and control its course.
Alright, so see if we can find something in Google. Got an etymology. Bring it out.
It's helm in the etymology online. It says an instrument by which a ship is steered.
Yeah.
Rubber position of guidance control.
See? Yeah, that's what it is. I don't even show the image. I don't even need to show the image. Right?
Right.
So now we understand what a helm is. Now you see, the Edomite woman over there, she was basically bowing down. Yeah, man, she was in the car basically bowing down.
Over and over.
Over and over, man. She already knew what it was when she seen it. That's why we was reading them scriptures, man. These people out here know that we're different. Now, if I would have shined the camera over there, you would have seen her bowing down in that car, man. Letting us know, look, I'm doing this because of y'all. She was basically letting us know that. You know? The Edomite. You know, we ain't tell her to do that. That was the spirit. You know? That was the spirit. So, read that again.
All right, back in James chapter 3, verse 4. Behold, also the ships, which though they be so great and are driven of fierce winds, yet are they turned about with a very small helm,
yep,
whithersoever the governor listen.
Yeah, and then, go ahead.
Verse 5. Even so, the tongue is a little member.
Even so, the tongue is a little member. Because that tongue, you can be listening to somebody and call them your teacher. Whatever you learn from that teacher, your tongue is going to spew it out. Okay? Whatever philosophy that you learn from that teacher, your tongue is going to spew it out, that others may hear what you got to say. Okay? Go ahead.
And boasted great things.
And boasted great things. Okay? That's the way Esau's tongue is. Okay? He boasts of great things based off lies. You see? And by him boasting great things based off lies, the people that believe in Esau, they do the same thing because Esau is their teacher. Okay? So they spewing out things that are destructive. They're destructive to their course of nature. Okay? To their way of life. And by them allowing Esau to be their teacher, that's going to end up in destruction. Okay? Go ahead.
Behold, how great a matter a little fire kindled.
How great a matter a little fire kindled. So, by Esau pushing out the vibration that we are African American, Puerto Ricans, Cubans, Dominicans, Haitians, by him pushing out that vibration, that tongue, that stuff that he spewed out, he covered up a great matter. Okay? Because hiding the fact that the children of Israel are the judges of the earth, that's a great matter, man. Okay? That's a great matter, man. And hiding the identity of Yahweh Shema Washai, that's a great matter, man. And that ain't nothing but confusion. That ain't nothing but confusion, you see? And listen to the Esau, that's how two-thirds govern their life. Straight confusion, man. And headed for destruction. Because of Esau's tongue, man. Okay? And what he teaches. Go ahead.
Verse 6. And the tongue is a fire, a world of iniquity.
A world of iniquity, man. Like the brother was saying, like the brother was trying to explain, and I just said that's straight confusion. When you teach contrary to the scriptures, that's straight confusion, man. Okay? You ain't doing nothing but going headlong straight into destruction, man. Go ahead.
So is the tongue among our members.
Yep.
That it defileth the whole body.
It defileth the whole body, man. It defileth your body. Okay? And it defileth the person that listens to your body. Okay? So you gotta watch what you say. That's why Yahweh Shema Messiah said, look, I love him none that dwelleth in wisdom. But him that dwelleth in wisdom, man. Yeah, man. You gotta watch what you say out here. You gotta watch what you teach out here. Okay? Because you can teach things contrary to Yahweh Shema Messiah, cause you to be destroyed. Like you can be out here teaching about the Quran. You can be teaching out here about the Egyptian Book of the Dead. That's gonna lead you to destruction. You can be teaching about the Book of Enoch, but that's not the real Book of Enoch. That can lead you to destruction. so on and forth. You can be out here teaching that twisted Christianity that Esau came up with, okay? That he done mangled, that he done came up with. You can be teaching that. Straight confusion and destruction, man. Okay? Which can lead you into death, man. Judgment. Go ahead.
And set it on fire the course of nature.
And set up on fire the course of nature. So Esau basically, or anybody else teaching contrary to the scriptures, they altering the course of nature. Meaning, the people who listen to them, they ain't gonna enter into eternal life. So they're being turned into destruction instead of going in through the narrow path so they may enter into eternal life. You see, they altering the course of nature. Go ahead.
And it is set on fire of hell.
And it is set on fire as hell. Basically set up for destruction, man. Okay? Because that's what's going on. When you look that up, that goes into Gehenna, when they were burning trash and idols and unclean things in Jerusalem. So that's symbolic talk. That's symbolic talk for hell right there, meaning you're going to suffer judgment. You're going to end up in destruction. So continue on. Like, what's going on? You see what we got right here? See what, checking out what we got up here? All right, give me a second, Edwards. If you got a question, just hit it with me. You know what I'm saying? But what I want is second Ezra, the I think it's like the sixth chapter. No, hold on, the seventh chapter. You hear me? If you got a question about this, all you got to do is ask anything, right? That's number seven. Thought it was top.
All right, this is 2nd Ezra chapter 7, verse 1.
Go ahead.
And when I had made an end of speaking these words, there was sent unto me the angel which had been sent unto me the night afore.
Go ahead.
And he said unto me, up, Ezra, and hear the words that I am come to tell thee. And I said, speak on my power. Then said he unto me, the sea is set in a wide place.
You do know that that's not the Lord, though. You do know that, though.
Right, it's like a wrong interpretation.
Right, right. You do know he's, according to the Bible, he's a so-called black man. You do know that, right?
Right, I mean, I knew
you
that
you never read that?
I have.
Oh, okay.
But I know he was, I know for darn sure he wasn't lying.
Right.
So, what are you about?
I'm about teaching the King James Bible and telling our people, Negro, Latino, Native American, salvation is for them. That's who the Lord, who the world in the cause, Jesus, God, according to the King James Bible. Contrary to what we've been taught in the world. When you read the Bible, what these people say in the world is totally different. You know, when you study and read it, when you start going into the Hebrew and the Greek, you start looking up words, you find out that these people in these churches or in the world don't know what they're talking about when it comes to the King James Bible. This is our heritage. These people on the side, they go like, you know, in America. And salvation is only for them. Give me, what you got? But I want to go back there later. But give me John 3 and verse 16. Well, you can start at 14 and hold Numbers, I think it's like Numbers, it might be 21 and 5, hold that. See, people ago, our people been taught to memorize John 3:16, but not everybody understands John 3:16, okay?
How so?
I'm going to show you.
Okay.
See?
Alright, this is,
you ready?
Okay, go ahead. This is John chapter 3, verse 14. As Moses lifted up the serpent.
Now, I got a question. Have you ever read the whole chapter of John 3:16? Or you just know about John 3:16? I can't hear you, you gotta speak up.
Oh, my bad, sir. I just know John 3:16.
You just know John 3:16. Right. So what we doing, I'm gonna tell you, it was the Lord and Nicodemus that was having a conversation. Okay? And the Lord was explaining to Nicodemus what gotta take place concerning him. Okay? So go ahead.
Alright, this is John chapter 3, verse 14. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up.
Now, do you understand what he's talking about right there?
None.
Okay, I'm on flight.
This is All right, this is John chapter 3, verse 15. That whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Verse 16. For the Most High so loveth the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
See, that's what you understand. That's what you have been told, that according to that, it's for everybody. But we finna go back up and I'm gonna show you something. Start back at 14 again.
All right, this is John chapter 3, verse 14. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness.
Now, let's find out where Moses lifted up the serpent. Give me Numbers 21 and 5. Now, he was talking to Nicodemus. So we got to get an understanding of what he's referring to. And he's talking to Nicodemus about the Moses and the serpent. Go ahead.
All right, this is Numbers chapter 21, verse 5. And the people spake against the Most High and against Moses.
Now, that was in the wilderness. You had the children of Israel in the wilderness after they left out of Egypt, after they was freed from bondage in Egypt. Okay, go ahead.
Wherefore have ye brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness?
See, go ahead.
For there is no bread, neither is there any water, and our soul that lofteth the light of bread.
Go ahead.
Verse 6. And the Lord sent fury?
Yep, fiery.
Fiery serpents among the people.
So the Heavenly Father sent fiery serpents among the people, okay? Because of their rebelliousness in the way they was talking against the Heavenly Father.
Go ahead. And they bit the people, and much people of Israel died.
Go ahead.
Therefore the people came to Moses and said, we have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against thee.
See? Go ahead.
Pray unto the Lord that he may take away the serpents from us.
See? Go ahead.
And Moses prayed for the people.
Go ahead.
And the Lord said unto Moses, make thee a fiery serpent.
See? And remember, keep that in mind. Fiery serpent. Go ahead.
And set it upon a pole. And it shall come to pass that every one that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live.
So anybody that looked upon that serpent was going to live. But why did Moses have to make that serpent like that? Because the people back then were sinning against the Heavenly Father. Okay? So what people was there in the wilderness? It was only the Israelites. It wasn't all these other nations. I'm gonna show you all these different nations that's in the scriptures. There it is right here. This is the table of nations, right? I hope. This is the table of nations, right? And got the Israelites right there, right? And you got all these other nations. These are all the other nations that's mentioned in the King James Bible. Okay? The only people that was in the wilderness with the Heavenly Father at that time was these people right here.
Okay?
Not all of them. So the only people that were sinning and looked up on that serpent was these people right here. This is what I'm showing the brother. That sign right there. These were the only people that were back there looking at that serpent. So read that again. Where you left off.
This is Numbers chapter 21, verse 7. Therefore the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against thee. Pray unto the Lord that he take away the serpents from us." And Moses prayed for the people.
Right, go ahead.
So verse 8. And the Lord said unto Moses, "Make thee a fiery serpent."
See, the Lord said unto Moses, "Make thee a fiery serpent."
Go ahead.
"And set it upon a pole."
Uh-huh.
"And it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live."
So why did they have to look upon that serpent? Because they were sinning, right? I'm repeating myself, so I'm trying to make sure you follow me. You ain't going to sleep on me. You ain't lost. Okay? That's what I'm doing. So we on the same page, right? That's the reason why they had to look upon that serpent, because they were sinning. And the only people that was back there at that time were Israelites in the wilderness who were getting bitten by the serpent. These are the Israelites and Moses. Okay, go ahead.
So verse 9. And Moses made a serpent of brass and put it upon a pole. And it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived.
Okay.
Verse 10. And the children of Israel.
See, and the children of Israel. No other nation. Children of Israel. Go ahead.
Set forward and pitched in above.